Now, do children understand morality versus social conventions? Well, here's an interview with a 4-year-old girl about a moral issue. She has seen someone hit another boy. The experimenter asks her, "Did you see what happened?" She says, "Yes, they were playing and John hit him too hard." The experimenter says, "Is that something you're supposed to do or not supposed to do?" She says, "Not so hard to hurt." The experimenter says, "Is there a rule about that?" She says, "Yes." The experimenter says, "What's the rule?" She says, "You're not to hit hard." The experimenter says, "What if there was no rule about hitting hard? Would it be all right to do then?" She says, "No." The experimenter says, "Well, why not?" She says, "Because he could get hurt and start to cry." Here, the 4-year-old girl is understanding that even in the absence of a rule like you can't hit people, it's still not okay to hit people. She has a sense of morality. She can operate in a way that we would consider moral, even in the absence of a specific rule. In terms of a conventional issue, the 4-year-old girl watched another child who got in trouble for being noisy. The experimenter says, "Did you see what happened?" She says, "Yes, they were being noisy." The experimenter says, "Is that something you're supposed to do or not supposed to do?" And she says, "Not do." The experimenter says, "Is there a rule about that?" And she says, "Yes, we have to be quiet." The experimenter says, "What if there were no rule? Will it be all right to do then?" And she says, "Yes." The experimenter says, "Why?" And she says, "Because there's no rule." Here she's separating out moral issues from social conventional issues. If you take away the rule for a social convention, it's okay to do. If you take away the rule for a moral issue, it is not okay to do. So even at the age of 4, children are starting to separate this kind of stuff out. They're understanding that some things should never be done, and some things are okay to be done if there's no rule against it. And, of course, that 4-year-olds are able to do this contradicts the work of both Piaget and Kohlberg.